Following the previous case study where I attempted to create a rip between a floating boss and a cone, I got a suggestion from Commander Goggles on a better way to do this. There were also a few other comments along the same line. I want to thank all of you for the suggestions. So let's take a look at this new workflow. Instead of extruding in the Y direction, we are going to extrude in the X direction. We can create a plane in the middle to do this, but that would be arbitrary. To keep this parametric, let's create a plane tangent to the boss. Go to Construct, Tangent Plane. Select the cylindrical face of the boss. Let's show the primary planes. Select the right plane as the reference plane. This will make the new plane parallel to the right plane. Create a sketch on the new plane. Let's hide the cone for clarity. Draw a straight line down the middle. Since I will be using a thin extrude, there is no need for a closed profile. Finish the sketch and bring back the cone. Begin the extrude command. Select the thin extrude option and select the sketch line. Set the direction to two sides. Before we start changing the other options, I would advise you to first set the operation to join. For side 1, we have the option of using all or two object. If we select all, the extrude will automatically extrapolate up to the nearest face, which is the conical face. We can also use the two object option and select that face. Adjust the thickness and wall location. I will set this to center, so that the thickness is symmetrical about the sketch line. For side 2, if we set the extend type to all, you will find that it goes through the boss. In this case, we have no choice but to use the two object option. And select the cylindrical face of the boss as the object. Adjust the thickness and wall location. Make sure that the extend option in this case is to body instead of true body. So we have created a rib that conforms nicely to the cylindrical boss face and also the conical face, with no excess on the other side. This workflow has two major advantages over the previous workflow. The rib thickness can be adjusted independently from the boss thickness. And because we are sketching on a plane that is tangent to the boss, when we change the location of the boss, the rib will update accordingly.